Hi, in this video you will learn how to make this Android game from scratch using only Android Studio and Java. Let's get started. If you want to master Android apps and games development, then click subscribe and the bell icon and let's do this together. Open Android Studio and create a new project. Let's check out the resolutions of the image files that I will use in this game. I will copy these images and paste in drawable folder under RES. Let's create a layout resource file called startup.xml, which will display a background image and a button to start playing the game. Let's write the XML code for startup.xml. If you are not familiar with layout designing by writing code in XML, please check out some of the videos in this playlist. I will put a link in description as well as in the info card. You can find the info card at the top right corner of the video. Next, create a new Java class that extends AppCompatActivity. Override onCreate. define the start game method. Create an intent object and pass it to the startActivity method. So when the button is tapped in startup, startGame method is called from where main activity is launched. Finish the activity. I will delete this unused import statement. Go to main activity and in the setContent method, I will basically create an object of Space Shooter class. I will define this class later. Let's define a class called Enemy Spaceship responsible for managing the enemy spaceship bitmap. Declare the required object references and variables in class scope. Define the constructor that initializes context, enemy spaceship bitmap, random object, and calls reset enemy spaceship method. We will define this method below. Define getter methods to get the enemy spaceship bitmap, enemy spaceship width and height. initialize EX, EY and enemy velocity in reset enemy spaceship method. Similarly, create the Our Spaceship class responsible for managing our spaceship. Next, create a class called Explosion responsible for managing the explosion animation. Next, define a class called Shot responsible for managing the missiles. Next, let's define the most important Space Shooter class. It's a custom view class, so we will extend view class and override onDraw and onTouchEvent methods. Write our drawing methods and business logic here. First, declare some object references and variables in the class scope. While importing handler, make sure to import android.os.handler package, otherwise you will get an error. Define a runnable object, override run method and call invalidate from run. That will call the onDraw method. Define the constructor of this class. Call super and pass the context that we receive in constructor. Instantiate the context, random, and ArrayList objects. using the display and point class compute screen width and screen height. Next, instantiate our spaceship, enemy spaceship, background, life image, handler, and score paint objects. Oops, I forgot to extend View. Let's quickly extend the View class. Override on draw method. call draw bitmap method on canvas object and pass the background bitmap, left top value, and for paint pass null. Draw the points. Draw the life images. When life is 0, set true to paused and null to handler. Create an intent, put points as extra, start activity with the intent and finish the current activity. So this will basically launch the game over activity and points will be passed to that. Add enemy velocity with enemy spaceship.ex for a left to right movement of enemy spaceship. When enemy spaceship touches the right edge of the screen, reverse its velocity. When enemy spaceship touches the left edge of the screen, again reverse its velocity. This way, enemy spaceship moves between the left and right edge of the screen. when enemy short action is false and the x value of enemy spaceship is greater than or equals to 200 plus some random value between 0 and 399, create a short object called enemy short, add this short object to enemy short's array list and set enemy short action to true. When enemy explosion is not true, draw the enemy spaceship on canvas. When our spaceship dot isAlive boolean is true, check if the x value of our spaceship is greater than screen width minus width of our spaceship. If it is true, then assign our spaceship dot ox with screen width minus width of our spaceship. Else if the x value of our spaceship less than 0, assign our spaceship dot ox with 0. This way, our spaceship does not cross the left and right edge of the screen and stays on the screen. Also, draw our spaceship on canvas. Use a for loop and iterate from 0 to 1 less than enemyshots.size. Add 15 with the Y value of each enemy shot object for a top to bottom movement. Draw the enemy shot objects on canvas. If an enemy shot object collides with our spaceship, decrement life by 1. Remove enemy shot object from array list, create an explosion object and add this explosion object to explosions array list. when the Y value of an enemy shot object goes below the bottom edge of the screen, remove it from enemy shots array list. When the size of the enemy shots array list is 0, set false to enemy shot action. Repeat the same process for hour shot movement and collision detection with enemy spaceship. If collision is detected, we will increment points by 1. Next, write code for explosion frame by frame animation. Iterate a for loop from 0 to 1 less than the size of the explosions array list. Draw the explosion frame on canvas. Increment explosion frame. When explosion frame of each explosions object is greater than 8, remove it from explosions array list. If paused is not true, call pauseDelete method on a handler object and pass runnable object and update_millis. This will call the run method of runnable after 30 milliseconds. From run method, we have called invalidate method, which will basically call the onDraw method. And this way, we have created an infinite game loop. Overwrite onTouch event and get the x coordinate of touch. When the motion event is action_up, we will check if the size of our shots array list is less than 3. If true, we will create an object of shot called our shot and add to our shots array list. The motion event action_up is triggered when you lift off your finger from the screen. So, in this way, we have enforced this condition that only 3 shots can be displayed or drawn on the screen simultaneously. When the motion event is action underscore down, that is when you just touch the screen, assign touch x to the x value of our spaceship. The motion event action underscore down is fired when you just touch on the screen. When the motion event is action underscore move, we will also assign the touch x to the x value of our spaceship. The motion event action underscore move is fired when you move your finger on the screen. Go to res, values, themes.xml and add this style tag to make your app full screen. Next, open AndroidManifest.xml and refer this theme for Android:theme attribute. You can delete the meta-data tag since we don't need it for our project. We are required to add an activity tag for startup. So just copy the activity tag and paste below. Change the name to startup. And delete the intent filter tag since we don't need intent filter tag for startup activity. It is only required for main activity. That is the launcher activity. Change the orientation to landscape. Just copy that and paste inside the activity tag for main activity. Go to spaceshooter.java. Comment out these 3 lines. And run the application to check the output. As you can see, the game is loaded. Enemy spaceship is moving in between the left and right edge of the screen. A missile is fired when you lift your finger off of the screen. If it hits the enemy spaceship, you get a point that is displayed on top left. On the top right, your life is drawn. If our spaceship is hit by enemy missile, you lose a life. Once a player lost all 3 lives, the app closes. So far, so good. We just have a small issue here. When you run the app, we can't see the play button and the game automatically starts. It's because we have set main activity as launcher activity in manifest by mistake. But the launcher activity should be startup, right? So just cut and paste the intent filter tag from main activity to startup if you want to use startup as launcher activity. Next, create the layout resource file for Game Over activity. Write the XML code for this layout. In this tutorial, I will not explain XML layout designing since I have already created many videos on this topic. You can check out some of the videos in this playlist if you are eager to learn layout designing. I will put a link in description as well as in the info card for your reference. Check out the design in landscape mode. Alright, looks okay. Now, let's define the game over class by extending AppCompatActivity and override onCreate method. We will also define the restart and exit methods here. Declare the TextView object reference for showing points in the class scope. Call setContentView and pass the layout resource ID for game underscore over. Get the points extra from intent and store in an integer variable called points. Initialize TV points by calling findViewById and passing the ID of TV points. Set TV points with points. I have concatenated points with empty string to convert it into string. But you can use string.valueOf method here. Let's define the restart method that takes a view parameter. In this method, create an intent object. And start startup activity with that intent object. And finish the current activity, that is game over activity. Define exit method and call finish from this method. This will basically close the app. Go to spaceshooter.java, uncomment these 3 lines and run the app. When you lose all 3 lives, the app is crashed. Let's check out what error we are getting in Logcat. Activity not found exception. Unable to find explicit activity class. Game over. Have you declared this activity in your AndroidManifest.xml? No, we haven't. Let's quickly define this activity in Android Manifest. I will copy this activity tag, paste below and change the name. Let's run the app one more time. As you can see, the game is loaded. Enemy spaceship is moving in between the left and right edge of the screen. A missile is fired when you lift your finger off of the screen. If it hits the enemy spaceship, you get a point that is displayed on top left. On the top right, your life is drawn. If your spaceship is hit by enemy missile, you lose a life. Once you lose all 3 lives, game is over and your score is displayed in game over screen, where you can restart the game or exit from it. Perfect. I hope you enjoyed this video and learned something from it. Thanks for watching and see you in another tutorial. Take care. If you find this tutorial useful, please like and share the video and subscribe to my channel for more tutorials like this.